Welcome. Thank you for joining me today. In today's episode, we are going to talk about wireframing, what it is, when to do it, how to do it. So what is a wireframe? Wireframes are low fidelity, grayscale illustrations that represent the structure and content that will appear on web pages or app screens. So why do we do wireframing? Because wireframes are cheap, easy to produce, easy to change, they allow exploration, and they communicate early design concepts. If this is a wireframe, and this is a wireframe, and this is also a wireframe, then what is the difference? Well, the difference is fidelity. Choose the fidelity based on the group you would like to share your wireframes with. If you're working on a personal project, you are probably fine with pen and paper. However, if you would like to share your wireframes with clients, I would probably go with a high fidelity wireframe because it just looks more professional. I like to do wireframing just using paper and a pen. Nowadays, I tend to use my tablet more often, but I don't carry this with myself to the office. So when I am in the office, I usually just use pen and paper. My website needs a page about me. So for this video, we are going to wireframe my about page for my website. So first, what I do is I write down all of the elements that need to be on the page, which is the logo, menu, image of me and a blurb about me with introduction and links to my resume and all of my social media sites that I want people to know about and a footer. Okay, let's pull out the paper and pen. So first I write down all of the elements. And once it's done, I'm just sketching out a few ideas. I don't limit myself. I don't judge my ideas. Because in this video, we are working on my about page. So this is a personal project. So these wireframes need to make sense to me. So I know that the circle is the logo and the lines represent some kind of text, either a menu or a blurb or a description or introduction. And the box at the bottom is the footer. To be able to wireframe, you don't need to know the exact text, but you do need to know there is a text element on the page. There's a really cool technique, it's called Crazy 8. So the idea behind that is, you fold your paper like this. Crazy 8 is great to generate ideas very quickly. How you do Crazy 8 is you set a timer for 8 minutes and then you start sketching 8 quick ideas. You spend 1 minute in each box. And when a timer pings, then you stop sketching. If you do this with your team, then ask people to present their top ideas and then ask them to dot vote for their favorite idea. Make sure you have one idea per box. Crazy 8 is a fantastic method, although I like to break the rules. And you know, sometimes time doesn't allow us to go through like even an 8 minute session. So instead of Crazy 8, what I do is Crazy 4. It's exactly the same concept, but instead of 8 boxes, you have 4 boxes. And you go through the same cycle, so you ask people to dot vote. Or if you just sketch all of these things out for yourself, then you dot vote for yourself. And then you can explore further on your favorite idea. With another pen, you're just like, okay, I like this one and I like this one. So, and you dive into these things and this is like, okay, this is not good, not good. When I do digital sketching, I do exactly the same thing that I showed you earlier. when I use pen and paper. So here I'm using an app called Concept, but you can use Procreate or whatever is your favorite tool that lets you draw. By adding the element's name to the page, I'm making sure that I have all of the necessary elements so I didn't forget anything. Now let's move into Figma. As you can see, I already imported two images that I liked, and I think I'm going to go with the last one. And I'm just moving this out of the way. And let's do the wireframing. So the circle is still the logo, and I'm adding the menu items that I want to display on my About page. I add the title there, a page title. And this gray box is basically my image, and I'm adding a blurb about my experience and the footer with some links and some extra text. And now this is ready to be shared with the world. So if you would like to get feedback on this from your clients or from your team, then you can just export the image and share it with them. And that's all about wireframing from me. I hope you enjoyed this video and find it useful and valuable. Please come back next time and subscribe to my channel. I create weekly videos about design, UX design, and product design, and I hope to see you here again soon. Bye!